Remembered the other thing about Sammy, my friend who shops where I work, the Muslim man, same birthday as me, May 29th, JFK's birthday. So he's 61 this year. He was born in 1961, and he is 6'1" tall. That's what it was. Yep. Delightful man. And then the 529, I told him this, our birthday, May 29th, which was originally 329, but 529, 5 plus 2, 7 plus 9, 16. 6116. He's 61, born in 61, and he's 6'1". Sammy! Same me. My cat growing up, the little black cat who taught me, probably taught me more about love than any other being in this lifetime. Sam. Sammy. Named after Sam of Bewitched. The cat lived to be about 24, I think, about that. And she was an outdoor cat too. She used to follow me and my brothers to school. My brother Jason told me that she used to do the same thing to him a couple years ago. He told me this. I didn't know she did it to him too. We'd walk, 2 miles to school or something, and this little black cat would follow us, and I would always be scared for her. Like, what do you do? Look at all these busy streets. What, like Paradise Road here? It's like, oh my gosh. And I'd be worried when I got home that she wouldn't be there, but there she'd be. She's like, what are you worried about? Look at my nose. I can smell, I smell good. My nose works right, I can smell my way home. She was so affectionate, so loving, such a beautiful little creature. I was kind of mean to her when we first got her because I was, pissy toward my mom, and it was her cat, so. This is when we were living on Crescent Street in the Blue House. And even after I was mean to her, she still showed nothing but love toward me. And then finally I broke down. Like, all right, yeah, I get it. Real love is forgiving. It does not begrudge. So look at this one here. This one is shocking. I have 5 more. I have 14 of these from yesterday. This was a total of 56 items in the purchase. And the total of the purchase, total was 152, right? I didn't even notice this till this morning. I didn't notice that yesterday when the customer lied. I don't think I did anyway. $152 total. Then look at the time. 152. 52 weeks in a year. Number value in English gematria of the word now. 52. And many others. 56 items, and look what the total ended in. 152.56. So, the time matched up with the total, and the dollar amount, 152, and the cent amount, 56, aligned with the number of items. 1 plus 5 is 6, plus 2 is 8. 8, 8. 5 and 6 is 11. 11, 11. 7, 11. Even. What the hell is going on here? 5:40 p.m. 109.25 total. And look at the 17th hour. 40th minute, 29th second, total 10925. My cashier number and birthday, 529. Invoice number 7677. I was born in 76. number value of power and master in English, and then 77, number value of Christ and Smurf. 18 items, 1 and 8 and 9 of the Sacred Feminine. Hallelujah. 4:07 p.m., 16th hour, 17th minute, 29th second, 2790 total. 729, 729. p.m. Total 3320 at 420. 16, 20, 39. 4367. Look at the invoice number. 7667. Total 4367. 7667 invoice number. That's the order of the transaction on the on that check stand. Number 6. See, because the reprint 7668 there. 13 items. 7 and 6. 13. Alright, that's it for the synchronicities for yesterday. I will put these away. The sun right now is in Aquarius, Aqua Osiris, here in February, Fumaries, moving into soon Pisces. Aqua Osiris, Aquarius, the father, Pisces, Piscis, the mother, and Aries, Arise, Horus, the child, the three of electricity. 3 o'clock, the position in the east, E, three of the house of the rising sun. Horus on the horizon, the divine child of electricity, electricity of the 1-2 tree of the Tropic of Cancer of the summer summit, 12 o'clock, the Tropic of Capricorn, the winter valley of 6 o'clock, and the equator in between the two, the twine of the twilight zone between, holding the tension of the pairs of opposites. Of Adam and Eve, odd, even, Aries, Libra, dawn, evening, Mars, Venus, male, female, yang, yin, sun, moon, day and night, deity, body and psyche, the mud and the apple, the raw material of Ra, arise, Aries, Hora, Sizon, the horizon, and the unrefined and the refined, the higher synthesis of Eve, of the apple that you can eat at the west line of the waist, of Libra in the hips, of balance, of all equations at the equator, of equilibrium, equilibraum, of Lyra and Livra, the liver.
We just heard the album Jazz Giants 58. It's like an all-star album here with Stan Getz on the tenor sax, Jerry Mulligan on the baritone, Harry Edison on the trumpet, Oscar Peterson on the piano, Herb Ellis on the guitar, Ray Brown on the bass, and Louis Belson on the drums. The piece we heard was the Ballade, which has consisted of a number of standards: Lush Life, played by Mulligan; Lullaby of the Leaves by Edison; Making Whoopee by Brown; and It Never Entered My Mind by Stan Getz. Time right now is 10:59, just coming up to 11 o'clock, and you're tuned into the Jazz Spectrum here on WHRB Cambridge, 95.3 FM, also streaming live.
The moon right now
at WHRB.com
is waxing, going to full. And Valentine's Day tomorrow, Eros Day.
Miles Davis, his album Love.
Full on the 19th.
Hope you enjoy.
Eros Day of the arrows of Cupid, of the cup id, of the chalice of Alice for the phallus, and the flowers, and the Proto-Indo-European root bell. of all blowing, swelling, and inflating, and blessing of the blood of the blade. We're in this section, three types of people from Osho's spiritual path. Truth is a pathless land, said Krishnamurti. So, the last line that I read was, wherever he is, the constant call from the unknown will be knocking at the door. Waking, he will hear it. Sleeping, he will hear it. Dreaming, and the knock will be there. He will hear it. Eating, he will hear it. Walking, he will hear it. In the market, he will hear it. It will be haunting him all the time. And now what's Osho gonna say right after I mentioned Krishna? I didn't know this was coming. On page 317. That's why Krishnamurti always said that there is no need to do anything. That's what he just said right there. Look. I seriously didn't know that was coming. Krishnamurti, who said it is no measure of health to be well adjusted to a profoundly sick society. That's why Krishnamurti always said that there is no need to do anything. In fact, for the first-rate type of person, there is no need to do anything. Just by hearing, by right listening, one attains. But where to find the first-rate person? They are very rare. Unless a Krishnamurti comes to listen to Krishnamurti, it won't happen. But why should a Krishnamurti go to listen to a Krishnamurti? It is absurd. It has no meaning. A person with that kind of perceptivity can become awakened just by listening to the song of a bird. Just by listening to the breeze passing through the trees. Just by listening to the sound of water flowing. That's enough, because from everywhere the truth speaks. If you are perceptive, whatsoever you hear, you have heard the truth, you have heard the Tao. Nothing else exists. All sounds are divine. All messages are divine. Everywhere is the divine signature. Signator. For the first-rate mind, the path is not a path at all. The person simply enters the temple without any path. There is no need for any bridge. Lao Tzu says that when the highest type of person hears the Tao, there is an immediate perception, an immediate understanding. Just by looking at the master who has attained, just by hearing his word, or just by hearing his breathing, silent, peaceful, sitting by his side, he understands. Once this type of person understands, then they are not trying to attain truth. They are simply trying to refine their mechanism. They have understood the truth. It exists. They have heard it. Hindus call their scriptures Shrutis. The word Shruti means that which has been heard. Once a man of the first-rate intelligence hears truth, he understands it. Once it happened that a Sufi master suddenly called one of his disciples. Many disciples were sitting in the hall, but he called only one. Come near to me. He was standing near the window, and it was a full moon night. All the disciples watched in wonder. Why had he called the one? Then the old man indicated something outside the window to the young man and said, look, And from that day, the young man changed completely. The others asked, "What happened?" There was nothing we know. Only the full moon night. The full moon was there, of course. The night was beautiful, of course, but what has happened to you seems to be completely out of proportion. You are completely transformed. What happened? Hare Krishna. Aloha.